Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome to another Legends of Runeterra video here on the channel. This is, we're completing the other expedition we started doing. Okay, that was not English. Let me try that again. We're here in this episode for more of this expedition. I just crashed massively. I'm really tired. It's really late. And, ooh, I nearly pressed surrender. Really tired, really late, and I just completely and utterly crashed on the spot as soon as I started recording this video. But let me get, you know, my head back into it. Yeah, we're here for another episode of just another expedition. We have 4 wins right now with an aggro-style deck that honestly is not good. I don't like this deck, but we're somehow at 4 wins. We nearly lost in the previous game, around 2 wins. We went down 1, and then we went back up 1. So yeah, let's see if this deck does better than the other one that I thought was actually really good. That then got fucked over by aggro. I'm honestly not impressed how it seems to really be difficult to play control in this game. Like, I personally think the best card games are the ones where control is, rather than possible, it is the norm. So I really do hope they improve that in the future. But let's see what happens. I don't like this. I feel like I played against this exact same guy. At least those exact same 3 things. This is cool, I like this card. Actually, I like this hand. I really like this hand. Going second and all, but I really like this hand. Alright. I'm gonna wait on this. Just play a Lonely Poro for now. See what I get. I get a Fearsome Poro, the Sinister Poro. Alright. Does this tell me all the Poros I can get? It doesn't. I could just play the Hired Gun. I'm going to save it. I'm just going to attack with my Poro while he has nothing out, so that I can activate a Plunder for this guy. And now I can just play a 1-mana 3-3 and save that 1 mana for later. Why do I have to... Oh, because I can still play a Poro. Why are these Poros not lighting up? Do I play the Poro or do I save the 1 mana? I think I just save the 1 mana, so I can have mana for Fury of the North, right? I think that makes sense. I don't see myself needing this Poro right away. Next turn, I'm not really sure what I'll do yet either, so I think that makes sense. I can turn this Poro into a 4-4. That could be cool. What is he doing? He's killing a unit with 3 or less power. I could buff it with this, or I could just let him. Just gonna let him. Not worried about that. I'm gonna save my my tricks here. Actually, I'm just going to play this thing for now. Or do I... I could buff a Poro. While this still costs 2, just let that go to spell mana as well. Yes, I am thinking, dude. Give me some time. I could also just play this. I think I'm just going to... Well, he could still play something himself, right? Just gonna play another Poro right now. I don't think I want to play the boat. I do want to suit up something. So, okay. Let me then... I'll set the Fearsome one to a 4-4. While that effect is still buffed. He's letting his spells go, or his mana go to spell mana again. That's fine by me. I'm just going to attack first before he can do anything. If he wants to deal with one... Oh, I love this, the art with the wraith behind it. That's so cool. That's so cool. What is this? Create 2 mushroom clouds in hand. Okay, so he does seem to have quite a powerful Teemo deck. I'll just give that vulnerable for now and let my mana... Like, let my mana keep going to spell mana. I'm not particularly worried about that thing. Honestly, because this has Challenger, probably I didn't even need to do that, but I do want to play something this turn, so. Yeah, he's going to start filling my deck with clouds. Like, I'm actually going to save this for when he plays the... Ooh, stop with the lag. Yeah, my laptop does not like the mushrooms. Whatever animation they use for the mushrooms, it seems to be quite intense on the hardware or whatever it is. But I'm just gonna... Yeah, okay, he's playing the Teemo, so I'm just going to use the Jaw Hunters next turn. Or even I'll play it at the end of this turn to deal with the Teemo. Because now he's going to level up double the poison on Nexus Strike, though. That's not a problem just yet. Play another Lonely Poro, why not? Make it seem like I don't really have much going on. I'm okay with this. Oh, he has another one of these. Okay, that's a problem. Now that's a problem. I'm about to have 30 fucking Spore Puffs in my deck. That is a problem. I wish this were the Elusive Poro. I really do. Oh god, okay. Can't do much about it. I'll just play in this Poro while I can, because why not? He played this very well. He has exactly enough mana to do all this shit. Now that guy levels up before he even attacks. That's a problem. Like I keep saying, that is a problem. We don't have enough spells to deal with this shit. He's attacking with the 4-3. Makes sense. I'll chump block with this Poro. Do I ever Fury of the North to get this trade? No, right? I don't think I do. So I'll just block like so. And now we have 30 Spore Puffs in our deck, or Puff Caps. That's annoying. That's a really, really big problem. Now I'll finish the turn by playing this, catch him a little off guard, hopefully. Sea Monster allies have Fearsome. Attack, give enemies -2/-0 this round. Still 12 away from deep, though. This could help with that. I'm going to kill off the Teemo with this, and I'm going to kill off this thing with this, and then I'll just attack with the rest of my stuff. One of these at least has to deal damage to him, and I might actually save... I'll save this guy with Fury of the North if I get given the option here. I'm pretty sure. So let's see what he does. I mean, his hand is full. He's done nothing this entire game. So hopefully he doesn't have a way to keep this trade from happening. If he does, I can always just Fury of the North it. I love this card. This seems like a really good card. I mean, it's not great, obviously, but it's burst, so he can't interact with it. Yeah, okay, the ship goes down, which is kind of unfortunate, but oh well. He didn't block, which is nice. Did not block, which is nice. What are you? Round start, stun the weakest enemy. That's fine. I don't like drawing cards, obviously, but if we can get actually a card with one Spore Puff here, then I can heal that. I can heal for three, which is fine. Yes, it had one Spore. Oh, it had two even, but that's fine. And now we have a buffed this thing as well, so let's heal up, and then we're two turns off from being able to Riptide Rex, but that's okay. This guy's a bit of a problem, but he's going to stun the 1-1, right? I could just hire Gun now. I'm just gonna do it to say, like, I don't see us needing. Like, we can only. Yeah, I don't see us needing that much mana next turn, so I'm just gonna do it like so. I do like that that thing can be now. I can drag that thing out, so I can. Yeah. What? Why? That's not the weakest. This is the weakest. Okay, drew the one Spore Puff, and let me send this guy the. Hey! Wait, how does it go? The hype thing. So that he's like, yes, I'm aware your deck is cool, but you're on 8 health because you took your entire early game to get my deck full of Spore Puffs, so now how do you survive? Whenever another ally survives damage, granted +1/+0. That's fine. Not worried about that in the slightest. In the slightest. We're actually very close to just killing him here. Like, really, really close to just killing him. Yeah, okay, but he's playing a bunch of shit, which is annoying. I could just kill the 4-3. This is every round start. One of my things is going to get stunned, right? That's obviously not great. Next turn, we want to play the Riptide Rex, though. So I guess I'm just killing the 4-3 here. Well, let's see if he... he hasn't passed, right? So he still has to... Shit, if he passes, I get to do nothing this turn. Okay, I figured he'd attack, yeah. Good. I mean, it was a risk. If he didn't attack, I was pretty screwed there. But I think it's a risk I had to take. He's used all his mana. So I'm actually just going to kill this off. And honestly, I don't even need to lose all my things. I can just block like so and give this. And then actually, because he's used all his mana. So, ooh, that lag. Okay, let me check that everything is still recording. Let me finish clicking button. Let me just check that everything is still recording. Okay, it is. And I can just kill everything he has. So I feel like the Riptide Rex just ends the game here. I'm pretty sure. We also get to get 3 spell mana next turn, which is nice. This card didn't do anything, but whatever. And we drew a Static Shock. We're 1 mana off being able to use that, but I don't think it really matters. Because here, he can't block everything, right? So, unless he has a spell, and we can always Static Shock to try to blow him out a little bit, like if he somehow prevents this from being lethal, which it's not looking like he will, because the Riptide Rex does just clean up, I believe. Yeah, massively cleans up. This is going to do 6 damage to him, unless he plays something here, but that's a pretty cool card. I like that a lot. But this is just lethal now. This is just lethal now, I'm pretty sure, right? Because, oh no, it's not. It depends how many went into this. So, he takes exactly 3 after this happens. Unless he, that doesn't do anything. Why would he, okay, sure. Give him elusive all you want. Is that permanent elusive, by the way, for 2 mana? That's really good. I need to think about that for my constructed deck. That seems really, really powerful. Shoot him! Exact lethal with the Riptide. Wow, this deck actually made aggro is nuts. I don't like aggro. Aggro seems broken. Aggro seems stupid. How is this deck doing better than the other one? The other one was actually fun. This deck is just punching my opponent to death. But okay. Scrap Shot, toss 3 now, that we've seen that, that's not good. Monkey Idol for more removal, or Jagged Butcher for a Jaw Hunter. Jaw Hunters was really good that game, but Jagged Butcher was really good as well. I'm tempted. I'm really tempted to grab this. Jagged Butcher is really not that good, is it? I think this is better. I think that's always better. I'm just going to grab that Jaw Hunter. Like, it's removal, and it gives you a card, and so it's like, it's moving away a little from the strict aggro of the deck, but I think that makes sense. I think that does make sense. Alright, we somehow made it to 5 wins, which I'm just like, what the fuck? How did we make it to 5 wins with this shit? But okay. Okie dokie. You know? Okay, I was about to say, are we not going to find someone? You can have a maximum of 6 champions in your deck. That's not a lot, to be honest. That's really not a lot. In Constructed, I've come to realize I kind of want, like, 7 or 8. But I suppose that makes sense. We're facing another Teemo deck. Teemo and Fizz deck. Hired Guns are going to be really good then. Do I even want to keep the Gacha just for the elusive bullshit? I think I do. I don't want to keep 2 Hired Guns, though, I'm pretty sure. I think even though we lose the... Well, if I'd known I was going to get a Mystic Shot, I never would have kept the Gacha, but whatever. Ooh, Fizz, what do you do? When you cast a spell, stop all enemy spells and skills targeting me and give me elusive this round. Okay, so his deck is going to be full of combat tricks, I'm guessing. But I get to attack here. So, do I just get to do this? Do you have a combat trick? You don't seem to have had a combat trick, because, oh right, because this is a minion. So, this is a thing, so it's not, you can't respond to that. Playing a 3-1 with quick attack. Yeah, I'm killing your Fizz. Goodbye, Fizz. Goodbye and good riddance. I didn't even read what it did when I leveled up. Out of curiosity, Fizz, what do you do when you level up? I can't check? I'm not allowed to check? Okay. Hang on, you can wait. What do you do when you level up, Fizz? I can't check, really? Alright, 3-1 with first strike. I'm just gonna shoot it. Thinking about it, do I just want to shoot it? I think I do just want to shoot it. Just gonna shoot it. And yeah, no blocks. Just gonna shoot it. If he does want to play the Teemo, we still have more removal for it, and I don't want to deal- I really don't feel like taking that damage. Like, this seems to be an aggro deck, right? So, still don't like this card, the Rummage, by the way. But whatever. What is this? Oh, sure. Is he just gonna do it? I mean, I guess it makes sense to just let it go to spell mana. No reason not to. Yeah, no real reason to do anything much. Just gonna play a 4-drop here. Still have 2 mana up. He can't attack this turn, so I don't have to worry about Teemo nonsense. This deck seems... I do want to try the Teemo deck, though. It does seem fun. It seems like the kind of thing that you do want to take a relatively control-y route with. Ah, that's annoying. That is annoying. Because now I can't attack with the 2-1, right? That is unfortunate. He's going to... Okay, that's fine. You block with the 4-3. I'm okay with that. Sure. Yeah, that's absolutely fine by me. Alright. I could have not attacked with the Elnuk there and saved that trade for the Jaw Haulers, but this turn we can play a Jaw Haulers and Gotcha something if, you know, that's something we feel like we should do. He's obviously trying to Spore Puff my deck before he plays the Teemo, right? But I'm making sure I'm killing that Teemo the turn it comes down. I promise you that. Thing is, he only has Teemos and Fizzes, so he'll have more than one, right, of them. So let's make this trade. Really, no spell. Why would you ever attack there? I could play the Wolf Rider, but that doesn't actually do much for me right now. I could just scare him into doing nothing by playing the... Well, I'm going to play this first. See what he does. Going to play this first and just see what he does. Because this will always activate the Wolf Rider next turn, which I actually do... I really do like that. Playing another Clump of Wumps. Okay. I mean, I'm not attacking with this, obviously. Well, actually, I might, because I have another one. I could attack with this, and we got a Beast Below. 12 away from deep. We can help help get there with Rummage, though. He has so many Spore Puffs in his hand. He's passed. Okay. I'll just pass two, then. Kind of want all these cards, so I don't want to Rummage. If I play this, chances are I'm just going to grab a Mushroom Cloud. So that's actually not good against them at all. I don't love this play, but I'm going to just get this trade in so I can get the extra 4 damage in. I kind of need to start doing damage to him, or these. Once he starts playing the poor the cloud puff thingies, it is gonna be the death of me. So I don't understand why he didn't play one last turn. He wasted 1 mana. So I really don't get that. Plays another 3-1 with quick attack. I see. I'm just going to play this. Get myself some extra mana, ramp up a little quicker. I think that's fine, honestly. Let's see, what else did he do? What else does he do? I'm kind of tempted to play this. Okay, I see, that's why. Yeah, I'm just going to play this now. Although he could just burst those in response. I'm about to have a million things in my deck, aren't I? Actually... Because thing is, these are burst spells, so you can just... Oh, I see how this deck operates. Ugh, that's a problem. Ugh, that is a problem. Just gonna do this. I can't stop him from putting... So what is that? That's gonna be 20 plus 12? That's gonna be 32 Spore Puffs in my deck? They are called Spore Puffs, right? I feel like they're really not. Puff Caps. Why do I say Spore Puffs? What is Spore Puffs from? I know it's from something. What is Spore Puffs from? Okay. That is bizarre. What is he doing? What is this? 6 plus cost spell from your regions, refill your spell mana. That's not very good. I mean, I understand why he did it, but now I'm allowed to steal that, right? Oh, he let me steal one of these. God damn it. Wait, that was a really cool card, though. What card was that? Flash of Brilliance. That's really cool. Wait, that's really cool. That is really, really, really cool. Okay, that's a really broken card. Yeah, I know. I'm getting a million of these. Sure. Why is Fizz upgrading? How does Fizz upgrade? Oh, just casting 6 spells. I see. I can discard that to this, though. which is actually not a bad play. I won't do it right now, obviously, but... Oh, I'm not in good shape. I am really not. Pocket aces is interesting. Two spore puffs inside. No, puff caps. Two puff caps inside. What is spore puffs from? I really don't know. Is he in deep? He's not. So this doesn't... Oh, but it's elusive. But I can trade this for it. Sure. Just going to play this for right now. Ah, this guy. I don't like this guy. Although I get to toss two. No, but then I shuffle two cards anyways, so it doesn't really help me. I think I just take three from the... Yeah, I'm just going to probably discard that guy. Let me actually do that now. See what I can come up with. So I'll discard... Yeah, I'll discard this guy and I'll discard that card. I do think I need a little extra something here. No spore cut. No spore. Spore. They're not spore puffs. Puff caps or whatever. I'll block and play this thing on it. Okay, I'm not blocking there though. So. Yep. I'm kind of allowing him to. Like, by allowing this to live, it's kind of risky, but if he does play a Teemo, I'm pretty fucked. What is he doing? Ah, that's unfortunate. That is really unfortunate. I might have to just shoot this then. Why hasn't this triggered? I'm afraid of the Teemo. That's the reason I'm not, obviously, but I'm just going to leave it be for now because I want to play another card this turn. I do want to play another card this turn, but like I'm not in a great spot right now. I can obviously just force this thing to block, to be blocked by this, so that's okay. Suit up, that would have been perfect last turn. Oh my god, I just took four. Oh no, this is bad. I should have just killed this and not worried about the Teemo. Ugh, I'm not in a good spot. I'm not in a good spot at all. Attacking with everything. Hopefully I can force some bad trades on his part. And, you know, catch him on off guard with my spells. That's kind of what I'm going for here. Oh wait, maybe I should have made that a 4-4, shouldn't I? I misplayed. I feel like I should have killed this guy a long time ago. I should have killed this guy a long time ago. How many spore puffs or puff caps? I still have more puff caps in my deck than I'd have cards. So he needs to die very soon. What is he doing? What are you doing, buddy? What the fuck are you doing? What is this? I hate that these cards go in the middle here and you just don't know what they are and then you're like, oh shit, what has happened? What? Two more? Okay, no. No, that's gotta be where I draw the line. This has got to die. He probably has Teemo at this point. But this is where I draw the line. He has to die. Also, I should have played the suit up on this when I was given the opportunity to again. That was my bad. Whatever though, whatever. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. I mean, I say this, I really don't think it is, but let's pretend like it's fine. Basically is what that means. Let's pretend like it's fine. If he has Teemo, I'm pretty sure I just lose on the spot. Don't be Teemo. Wait, no, that's a spell. Ah, I see. Fuck. I'm assuming that's, yeah. Ah, balls. Do I just let it die? I think I do. I think I just let it all die. Yeah, I really think he has Teemo now. I think I do. I don't think I win. I need to get really lucky on these puff caps to win here. I mean, there's only 24. Only. There's only 24 in my deck, right? Air quotes. So, can I not draw another card holding four of them? One, two, three. Oh, motherfucker. Yeah, that's game. That's game. I needed that card to have none. Oh, shit. Oh, thank you. Oh, my God, thank you. Oh, yes. Heal. Heal. Yes. Get fucked by your own card. Oh, please. Oh, please. Oh, please. Oh, my God, please. Play this, play this, play this, play this. Oh my god, just I'm dumping my entire hand, right? Hired gun. Okay, yeah, sure, you can make that thing block if you want. I'm not sure you do want, but... Oh my god, everything that just happened, what the fuck? Okay. Okay, please. Just not. Just three or less. Three or less. Three or less. Three or less. Oh my god, it's three. Oh my god, it's three. Attack. I'm not taking any risks. Just attack with everything. Attack with everything. Attack with every single one. Force this to block on the there. Sure. Don't really care. Okay, that works. Wait, I should have played this, but he's dead if he does nothing. So he has to do something, and then I can still respond, I'm sure. Beg your pardon? I'd imagine. I can still respond after he blocks, right? Okay, so he's taking exactly... Well, he's taking a little more than seven. Oh my god, wait, I need a wave on him. Hi, buddy. Oh my god, hi. One health! One health because he gave me the draw. One health. Oh my god, that's nuts. Please tell me it's recording. If there's a video that I want to go up, it's this one. Oh my god, the one health. Oh my god, I should feel worse than I do. I should feel worse than I do. I don't feel bad at all. I do not feel bad in the slightest. Okay, fuck you and your team of bullshit. Oh, I played that so poorly. That's bad. Sleight of hand for a pocket aces, maybe. I like the cutthroat. As much as I want a mystic shot, I like the cutthroat. That was so close. I played that reasonably well towards the end, but... Oh my god, that was nuts. Draw a random non-champion from the enemy hand, or pocket aces. I kind of feel like I need more combat tricks. I'm gonna make this trade. Sleight of hand has been pretty passable, but... Oh wait, we get six. Okay. Get excited over Monkey Idol. Monkey Idol's actually been pretty good. Bloodsworn Pledge is really good, but Chum the Water is better, I think, or just as good. And I really like Fury of the North, so skip. That is definite no. Take Heart. Grant the damage ally +3/+3. This guy's pretty... I mean, I like that guy. We don't have that many twos, right? So I do think we need him. And this is one of the best cards in my deck, so no, I'm not doing this trade. They Who Endure. When I'm summoned, grant me +1/+1. But for each ally that has died. Nope. Wolf Rider versus Thermogenic Beam. That's interesting, but I'm starting to understand how you're supposed to use the Wolf Rider. I mean, it worked in that game specifically. I'm not sure he's a good card, but I don't like Thermogenic Beam, although we really don't have that many spells. I don't know. This one's... I'm not sure about this one. I'm going to do it, but I'm not sure about that. Amateur Aeronaut versus Monkey Idol. I really like Monkey Idol in this deck. I really like the Prowling Cutthroat in this deck. Rummage against a suit up. Is a suit up ever better than a rummage? Probably, right? The rummage has been passively good, but I think suit up is just better. Okay, and the final trade we can make, we can give up a Pocket Aces, which we have three of, for another one of these. I actually do think we want to do that. Do we want a True Shot Barrage over a Coral Creatures? Probably, right? I like this card, but we definitely don't want that last one. But it's between these two. I think this card is just that good that it's worth giving up one of our Pocket Aces for. Even though I like Pocket Aces, that card is just that good. Whew! We only get one chance. Okay, we're doing it in today's episode, for sure. We are doing it in this episode. We only get the one chance. Let's do this. I can't believe this deck has got all the way to 7 wins. Or to 6 right now, but he has a fit. Okay, he's a heavy aggro deck. I honestly cannot believe this deck has made it this far. Really, really cannot. I'll keep the Mystic Shot. I guess I keep the Twisted Fate. Why not? Might be a bad idea, but this is not a great hand. Although against aggro, it's not a bad hand either. That is a terrible draw, though. That is an absolutely terrible, terrible draw. Can we get a 2-drop? We cannot. But we get a spell we can use. He has an attune card. Okay, that's fine. Do I ever just shoot that for lack of something better to do here? I don't think so. It's a 1-2, right? I'm not particularly worried about it. Yeah, I'll take the 1 damage. I think I need to save my removal for his actual things. If next turn we don't draw anything we can play, then... What is he doing? Ah, that's a problem. Do I get to see what he drew off my deck? That's really bad. So that was the reason to stop him from doing that. Oh, that's really bad. That's a problem. That's a really big problem, actually. I should have just killed this. Didn't think of that. Did not even occur to me. Oh, fuck you, game. Seriously? Turn 3 and I didn't even draw anything? Like, come on. What is this bullshit? Like, riggedy, like, right-ass fucking bullshit. Oh, God, dude, we're gonna lose. I'm pretty sure we just lost this game. Like, that's game over, right? Turn 3, still no play. Like, oh my God, this guy's deck. Holy crap, okay. Ah, that's so bad. How did we not draw anything? We have so much early game. Now we draw the 2-drop. Alright, well, that's just fantastic. So he has some more plunder shit that he's gonna use here. Presumably. Going to ignore the 1-2, just play this, draw a card. I mean, we already have full mana, but just gonna draw the card here. What is he doing? Yeah, shared spoils. Yep, figured something like that was coming. Do we not have hand limits in this game? I haven't seen that come into play yet. I just want this card. Like, if I can get this guy rolling as quickly as possible, I might be in an okay position, although that's a terrible draw. Oh, I'm so upset. That's the way this game's gone so far. It just, it really couldn't have gone much worse. I probably should have played the Elnook and not this guy, but... Where are you? When I'm summoned, draw a spell that costs 3 or less from your deck. That's a really cool card. Wow, that's a really, really cool card. Okay. This is not good, but maybe I can trick him into making a bad trade here. Either way, I want to activate Plunder for this. So, okay, he is just making that trade. I have enough mana to use my combat tricks rather freely for right now. So I'm just going to do one to this and one to the Nexus. Although that doesn't allow me to, like, that doesn't allow me to play this through it, but it's fine. I kind of want him to overcommit on combat tricks here. Like, this cycles itself, so it's not... It isn't that good to begin with, right? So if he overcommits here onto that 3-3, and I can blow him out with the Fury of the thing, I think I'm actually in a pretty passable position. Although, obviously, he has a trick in hand, right? Because he just drew one. That thing. Yeah, okay. Do I want to play Gotcha or Fury of the North? I think Gotcha is actually better to use in this specific situation. He could have another spell though, but even if he does, 3 plus 1 is 4, so that thing just dies before I even deal damage to him, so that's fine. I did just use all my I used all my mana for the turn, but that's okay. That's absolutely fine. What is he playing? He's playing, oh God, this guy is a tune. Holy crap, this guy's deck is good. I can't believe I let myself get fucked over by the coral creature. So that was off my own deck, right? He drew this from my deck. Because he doesn't have this. Yeah, he drew that from my deck, I think. No, he might have not. God, though. That card, that really fucked me over. Okay, that's passable. What did I swap this out for? I feel like something I kind of wanted to have right now. Oh, the 4-3, right? No, I actually do prefer having this for sure. It's kind of light on removal at this point. All right, this is intense. This shit's intense. I like his little fur ball there. Come on, dude. Come on. What are you doing? I can't believe we won that last game. Like, we shouldn't have won that last game, but what is this? He's making it vulnerable? This round only, and if it dies, he draws a card. I'll allow it. I will allow it. And then, this costs 3. I'm just going to play a 2-drop and leave my options wide open. I think that's better. Leave my options wide open. Like, I was debating playing the 4-3, right? But I think this is fine. He's attacking with everything, forcing that block, naturally. Naturally, he forces that block. I think I'm going to use the Fury of the North because, I mean, he has 5 mana. I don't know what 5 mana combat tricks there are in his classes, but He's playing something. Do I get to see what it is before I make my decisions? Give an stun an enemy and give all allies +2/+0. Okay, so in response to that, I can just give it +4/+4. And I think that's fine. Sadly, I can't block. Oh, I can block. I'm not sure how this works. I'm gonna do it. Not really sure how that works. Yeah, okay, just removes it from combat. So is that still blocked? It is still blocked. Okay. That's fine, though. I took a good amount of damage there, but I'm okay with... I don't love that I'm not at a very high life total right now, but I'm okay with everything that's happening on my screen. Here, I really do want to play this card. I don't think I'll have the opportunity to again, but I'm definitely attacking with both of these. I don't actually want to attack with this. Like, it blocks against this. Like, if he blocks with that... Actually, yeah, if he blocks with that, he still takes damage. And I might not want to use the spell this turn. So I'm going to attack with that, possibly. Offering that trade, exactly. Let's see what else he does. He has 7 mana, which is terrifying. I'm just going to take that trade, save the combat trick for now. The fact that we got to do damage means I get to transform this, like, plunder with this thing when it comes back into play here. How far are we on this? 5 of 8. Okay. I do want to play this by the end of his next turn, so that I can activate the plunder on this. Ooh, 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 I don't like this. Okay, so this guy's gonna die next turn. I can't stop it from happening, that's unfortunate. That's really unfortunate. Actually, I can. No, I can't. I can't. I can't. What are you? Can't block a 6-2 challenger. Okay, you are dying. Get the fuck out. Get the absolute fuck out. You must be crazy if you think I'm going to let my 6-6 die like that. Hell no. All right. So my 2-2 is most likely going to die here. Oh, there we go. I drew another Twisted Fate. That's fine. Shuffle a card from your hand into your deck to draw 3 fleeting at next round start. That's fine. That's all you're doing? Well, no, because this is a... How far are we? Oh, God, we're so close. No, it's next round start, so I can't even... It doesn't work. Just gonna skip the block, let that take the 2. That's okay. I get to play something, so I'll play a... I'll play a 4-3. It matches up well against this, and I actually want to play the Elnook and the Prowling Cutthroat still this turn before I do anything else. This is back to 0, right? I'm pretty sure this is back to 0. These are really hard to level up. Ah, I don't like that. I do not like that. That is not good in the slightest. He has another one of those. Okay, that's pretty bad for me, but I mean, I'll play the Elnook for now. I'm definitely getting this guy off next turn, which is, it's really important, for sure. I don't understand why you'd attack with that, or make any of these attacks, honestly, in general. I'll just take this trade. Yeah, very bizarre play on my opponent's part here. And I'll just play this to ensure I can get the... I don't even know that I want the Riptide Rex off next turn, but... What the fuck is this? Oh, so now it's a Fearsome Overwhelm 1-1 Poro. Interesting. That's removal. Do I want to just play... Do I ever play the Twisted Fate first here? Actually, I can deal 1 damage to everything he has. Do I ever want the Riptide here? Is the more important question. I think I can go another turn without playing the Riptide. So I'm just going to pick the red card here, actually. And just wipe out those Poros. I think this is fine. I mean, obviously he can then play something in, you know, on the backhand of that, but I can Pocket Ace or something. I can Pocket Ace, like... I think I'm in a pretty passable position, depending on what he does. He has a lot of mana and a lot of cards. Ooh, what is this? I see. Well, I'm attacking with both of these. Next turn I can deal with that, with the Chum the Water. Oh, I could have dealt with the Chum the Waters this turn, actually, but I'll just use this to just get that little trade. That's not fantastic. Actually, at all. Yeah, I misplayed that. Maybe I should have passed and let him make a decision. Well, I don't know. That was a rough turn. I definitely did something wrong, but So he restarts at one. That's unfortunate to say the least. There's the fizz. What do you level up into, my friend? I never got to read it. When you cast a spell, give me elusive and stop all enemy spells and skills. Okay, next is to create a chum the waters, which is what I have, right? But I have an elusive minion, so I can prevent him from doing that. Gonna take this slow and pretend like I don't have anything for that fizz for right now. Just play the monkey idol. And because I have an elusive guy. So even if he does want to give that elusive, I can block, right? Ugh. That's not good. That is not good. I actually... No point in playing the Chum the Waters again, right? Especially not targeting Fizz. He's obviously going to attack here. I think I might have to take 4, but he's obviously going to attack here, so I'm actually just going to pass for right now. What is he doing? I need to go to the bathroom. Ah, that's bad. Oh god, that's really bad. I need to go to the bathroom. Pretty bad as well. That's really bad. Him stunning that is a problem. I'm taking 7. And he gets to chum the waters. God, this is a problem. Dude, stop playing shit. I'm dead. Exact lethal. No! Ah, it's more than exact lethal. Fuck you! Oh my god! I did something wrong this game. I misplayed the previous turn. All I had to have done was attack first. Ah! Oh, I'm so upset. If I'd attacked before, if I hadn't played the guy and gone with my original plunder plan. God damn it! I fucked that up. Oh, I'm so upset. Trial complete. Damn it, guys. Damn it. Alright. Claim rewards. Let's see what we're getting at least. Common wildcard, rare wildcard, epic capsule, and 1,000 shards. That's not bad, actually. What did we get for this capsule? We got 2 commons, 2 rares, and an epic. Grant all battling followers ephemeral. I either have it or saw it. They're not that good, though. Seal an enemy follower this round. Oh, I'm so upset. I'm so gutted. That's pretty cool. I'm so gutted about that. That sucks. God damn it. Is that it? That's all I get? Alright, guys. Well. Ah, that was so close. We were so close. I misplayed that last turn and he had everything he needed. But absolutely. Ah, oh, that sucks. Damn it, that sucks. I was so close. Anyways, guys. Thank you for watching. I do hope you enjoyed this little expedition segment we did here on the channel. The next video I'm coming to you will probably be a constructed video, but I'm really not sure. I'm really enjoying these expeditions, so I wouldn't put it past me to just do another one. But yeah, I'm going to leave it here. F in the comments for... God, I'm so gutted. We got so close. So very, very, very close. On our very first expedition. Technically the second, but like, I'm counting that as the first. God, that is so annoying. That hurts. But anyways, thank you so much for watching, guys. I really, really do hope you enjoyed. And I hope you'll join us for the next one.